I'm Mr. Baldwin. 88 Mike Mondo, it's Miss Rusty, my name is Mike Levy, Justin Sane, and together we are Death Proof. And we're watching Milestone Wrestling on the list of television.
I'm Milestone Wrestling, Twist of Television.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Jason Dentino, owner-operator of Milestone Wrestling, and the voice of violence, lead announcer here. And?
Me, I'm Mr. Fantastic, Jerry F. Coffey, the voice of the fans.
Fantastic. Not with that hat, you ain't.
Well, according to the fans, I am, but that's according to the fans.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad y'all are here tonight. We're here, and we're here every Friday night at 7:30 on Charter Channel 10. We're a little different. We occasionally have blood. Well, kind of all the time. We occasionally have violence, right? Mm-hmm. There may be the occasional recreational drug usage involved in the show. And, of course, we occasionally have some cussing, too. Ain't that right?
Yeah, sort of like me sitting here and telling you that you and your little control can kiss my ass.
See, now that's just unnecessary, Jerry Coffey.
The fans think it's necessary.
Well, the fans are stupid.
Not as stupid as you. But anyway.
Look, if you've got something to say, say it.
Oh, I'm going to say it. Folks, you're going to see two great matches tonight. In the first match, you're going to see the Backwoods Juggalo, Johnny Ryder, going after that dirty, filthy Haven.
And dirty, filthy Haven?
Yeah.
Haven's not dirty and filthy.
You ain't been around him and smelled him, now have you?
He's not a Juggalo. He bathes.
And in the second match, which is the main event of the evening, you're going to see Mike Mondo defend the Milestone Revolutionary title against former champion Victorious and up-and-coming challenger Thomas Extreme. I promise, these are going to be tremendous matches.
That's disgusting. How dare a pot-smoking hippie like Thomas Extreme get me defend my title, chance at my title? That ain't. I don't like it.
Well, it's because he's a great wrestler and he deserves such an opportunity.
I don't think so. All right, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for this? It's time for Milestone Wrestling
Twisted Television.
It's time to get high with Milestone Wrestling. Saturday, March 12th, at the Newton National Guard Armory, Milestone presents its 8-man cruiserweight tournament. High speed, high flying, high action, high energy. See Nick Nitro, Thomas Extreme, Victorious, Rob Killjoy, and more. Plus the Hardcore Rumble. That's Saturday, March 12th, Newton National Guard Armory, only $8 at the door.
This is out. Well, that's pretty good. I'm stoned. Now this is getting high with Nick Nitro. Obviously, I'm already high. The porch is catching on fire. Ropes, wrestling ropes. Had a match last show, and I threw him off, and he hit the rope, and he hit the floor and fell on his head, and it was quite funny, I mean, for me, but, I'm a stoner, and so we laugh at stuff like that. I watched it a couple times, thought about sending it in, maybe getting 10 grand for it, shit like that happens. Jason Dentino. Man, what's up with Jason Dentino? He ain't got his head on right or something. He gonna sell us out to Extreme Money or whatever they're calling themselves nowadays? New Order? Some kind of shit? I don't even know what's up. We got so many groups and people popping up from nowhere. A lot of new faces in Milestone Wrestling. Milestone's doing a TV show this year, and we got commercials on big shows, and shit's blowing up, and it's gonna be a real cool year for Milestone. Jason Dentino, man. And Vic, he hit Thomas with the bong, and it just broke everywhere, and then they gonna take our tag belts, and it broke our bong. I ain't even worried about the tag belts. We could get that back and all, but they broke our bong, and that's kind of a big deal, to us. We have rituals as potheads, and that was our sacred bong, and we did a lot of good shit, and they broke our bong. Well, I don't know what we're going to do about this, but we're going to move on to the next chapter, and this is getting high with Nick Nitro.
7:30 p.m. Charter Channel 10. Milestone Wrestling debuts Twisted Television. Every Friday night, Milestone brings you another half hour of the most insane, intense, high-speed, high-action wrestling North Carolina has to offer. It's
Milestone Wrestling. Twisted Television.
Every Friday, 7:30, Charter Channel 10.
This is Haven versus the Backwards Juggalo, Johnny Rock. Johnny with the chair, Haven running away like a little scared man.
Well, you know, Haven's giving Johnny Rocker such a hard time the last two or three months, that I wouldn't blame Backwards Juggalo, Johnny Rocker for anything that he does this little punk Haven.
Well, look, Haven's needed to give Rocker trouble. Ryder needs someone to push him, to make him better. And that's what Haven's trying to do, trying to improve him, make him
improve
become a better
him.
Wrestler. Yes,
improve him.
He is teaching
me. Maybe your history is different from my own, but Jason Dentino, when these two started off, they were a tag team.
Yes.
And Johnny Ryder fully trusted Haven, and Haven stabbed Johnny Ryder in the back.
No.
Then,
now you're looking at it all wrong. You see, what happened was this. Haven and Ryder were teaming up, right? Haven saw something in Ryder, but he also saw that Ryder just didn't have enough fight, didn't have enough spark. And he wanted to encourage him to fight back and be stronger and be a better wrestler. He's trying to help him here.
He is a better wrestler because he don't have to take cheap shots.
Well, I mean, you know, there's nothing wrong with a cheap shot. Oh, God. So, most wrestlers, we have very few rules.
Yeah, but still, yeah, when a man's back's turned and he trusts you and you attack him from behind, that's a cheap shot. I don't care how you fluff.
No, he's taking beautiful side effect there from Johnny Ryder. Two. See, he's improving him. He's helping him learn to improve his craft.
To improve his craft.
Absolutely. Haven is giving of himself, of his own time, effort. He is helping him to become the wrestler that this disgusting Juggalo might someday be.
Disgusting Juggalo? So you're not done with the clans?
Well, I do have a Hatchet Man tattoo on my back, but you know, he's disgusting. Look at him. He's nasty, dude. Ooh. See, look at that.
And I'm going to have to deal with you every week.
Absolutely. See, Ryder there, sloppy cover, lazy cover. Did you just, once again, Haven goes in there and he's teaching Ryder.
It looks like Haven's running.
Haven is not running. He is improving Johnny Ryder's cardio. See, now they see
that. And then a cheap shot.
Wasn't cheap. It's legal. It's a street fight. They're trying to, you know, he's trying to mold this young man to a better, stronger person.
He is a better, stronger person. Or at least the Johnny Ryder I know is.
Ugh, you barely even know the guy.
I know, I've gotten to know him pretty well. I like him.
He can be better. He can do better. I mean, he's not really ready for the position that Haven wants him to have. Now see, look, he's gotten picked up see, this is what he's gonna teach him, how to not drink that nasty, cheap soda.
That's not nasty cheap soda, that's Faygo, man.
That's that nasty ghetto.
That's the best stuff out of Detroit.
Well, that's not saying much. I mean, come on. The best out of Detroit?
The only thing better than Faygo out of Detroit is Twisted and ICP.
What about Eminem?
Who?
Eminem.
Yeah.
Kid Rock?
Kid Rock's okay.
How about Detroit Rock City?
Kiss. Okay, you got a point. And Kiss.
Okay, see, now it's going to be good. Now look at that. Beautiful. Chandler got him hooked there.
Oh, and Sing Kiss hooked up.
Got him hooked up. Boom! Right there on the concrete floor. Makes him good, solid, makes him down. Haven, he is giving of his own time to help this young man become a better wrestler. I'm really a fan of Haven after this. I'm seeing how he's really wanting to take this young man and make him be bigger and better and stronger.
See, turn around thirsty, getting figured.
Well, I mean, you know. I can understand that. I mean, I don't understand when to drink that ghetto soda, but, you know, you can get a Pepsi or something. Oh, and he just got busted across the head. Back, head, back. Takes him down. Forearm shot to the back. Haven runs around, goes in, breaks the count. See, look at that. Beautiful professional wrestling right there.
And that explains why he's all halfway across the arena. Away from Johnny Ryder.
Absolutely. Once again, he's helping Johnny Ryder improve his cardio by getting more water in her. Oh, see, now he goes. Ryder goes and spits in his face. Throws him in the trash.
Right where Hazen belongs.
Piece of trash right there.
And you know what? Trash belongs in the can.
How dare he? Disgusting. See, and he don't even get the job done. Once again, that sloppy pin cover. Didn't hook a leg. Not enough weight across. Him. Just, you know, this is what Haven wants this guy to be. He wants him to be a better wrestler. He has cheese in his hair.
He has cheese in his hair.
Haven has a big glob of cheese in his hair.
Yeah, well, you know, he probably picked that up from trash can whenever Johnny Ryder put him there.
See, there's no reason he should have put him there. That was uncalled for. As this is a professional sport where they're supposed to be wrestling in the ring. And, you know, Ryder is over here trying to get just to foul up the whole match because he just doesn't know what he's doing. He's just not experienced. He's not really that good. Not like Haven. The hardcore horror.
Hardcore horror.
Horror.
Yeah, the hardcore horror. I heard you first.
Horror. Boom! Right across the face.
So he's the hardcore horror, Haven.
Hey, come on now. There's no need to use such language as that. It's unprofessional.
And you want to talk about unprofessional. Once again, you know.
Oh!
That's great.
Hooks him up. Hooks him. Boom!
Shakalaka!
Cover. 1, 2, 3. Your winner.
Johnny Ryder.
Yeah, well, he lucked out.
Lucked out!
It's time to get high with Milestone Wrestling. Saturday, March 12th. At the Newton National Guard Armory, Milestone presents its 8-man cruiserweight tournament. High speed, high flying, high action, high energy. See Nick Nitro, Thomas Extreme, Victorious, Rob Killjoy, and more. Plus the Hardcore Rumble. That's Saturday, March 12th, Newton National Guard Armory. Only $8 at the door.
The Notorious Victorious.
It's time to get high with Milestone Wrestling. Saturday, March 12th, at the Newton National Guard Armory, Milestone presents its 8-man cruiserweight tournament. High speed, high flying, high action, high energy. See Nick Nitro, Thomas Extreme, Victorious, Rob Killjoy, and more. Plus the Hardcore Rumble. That's Saturday, March 12th, Newton National Guard Armory. Only $8 at the door.
Milestone Revolutionary Champion Mike Mondo defending against the giant pot smoking hippie and Thomas Extreme and your future Revolutionary Champion Victorious.
The meth head.
It's no meth. There is no
meth head.
He does not do meth. He does not do anything. He is clean now.
Oh, whatever.
absolutely clean.
Wasn't he in the paper, like the Burke County paper, not long ago?
No, see, that was just false accusations.
Oh.
Beautiful reversal there from Thomas. I'll give him that.
A lot of power for Thomas to be able to pick Mondo up.
Crucifix, boom! Rolls
Crucifix
through with it.
Driver. Oh, Mondo's up.
Showing some strength. I mean, that's that special ed little yellow bus strength right there.
What?
Up. Boom! Drives him down.
Pretty move with pretty new gear. Mike Mondo right there.
Well, you know, nice to see some people getting some new gear around here. I mean, this place is starting to clean up a little bit. I'm starting to get rid of some of the trash around here. So we got the... Up. Ooh, 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 ooh. No. Woo! Rolls through. Move. I thought he was going for your... For your slingshot powerbomb right there for a second.
Looked like a little bit. Nah.
Kick that special it means guy in the face.
What? Come on, Mondo. Mondo reverses.
Scoop, reversal.
Boom!
Beautiful neck break. I'm gonna give the man this. I mean, he, you know, for someone who's, you know, should be riding a little yellow bus, he can learn to wrestle.
Yeah, Thomas just hit a perker on it. Didn't get all of it.
Well, I mean, he was probably seeing three or four of them, considering all the drugs in the system. Up, reverse, boom, lands it, up, and hits the stroke.
The stroke, just like Jeff Jarrett.
J-E-double-F.
Just like Jeff Jarrett. Sad to build too much, nobody wants to see you no more.
Hey.
What? But he's not champion now, because Mike Mondo's beat him last two times at wrestling.
Since Mike Mondo stole the belt with all your help.
What do you mean? Vic had 12 people cheat for him.
12?
Like 4 or 5, okay. And Mike Mondo still won the match.
Sure. Handful of tights, poked him in the eye. All kinds of cheating going
he's
on.
He's going away. He's the bonus suplex.
What the heck? I gotta give him credit on that one. Because Mondo takes out Thomas, Thomas takes out Vic. You notice Vic's smart rolls out of the ring where he can't be eliminated right now. Remind you, this is an elimination match. We here at Milestone don't believe in these little one pinfall wins the match crap.
Other than Rob Killjoy.
Well, you know, Rob Killjoy's weird.
Yeah.
But I mean.
But it's different than a title match. This is a title match. Champion should lose.
Yeah, he absolutely should be
should
pinned.
Should have to lose.
If you're going to lose that belt, you should be pinned.
There's no way that Thomas should be able to pin Vic without Mondo be pinning him and Thomas become champion. Because, I mean, that's the only other likelihood. Right.
Vic's gonna walk out of here with his belt.
Oh, Vic.
Yes.
He's gonna get hurt. He's gonna take a bunch of pain pills after the match. And man, I'm hurt.
I'm telling you, Vic is
pissed. Send me to the hospital.
Stop even insinuating this.
I guess he ain't been sent to the hospital a while ago. After, you know, I sent him to the hospital all the time.
Well, you tried to kill the man.
Yes.
Nice strength. Reversal. Up. Northern Light Super. Yes.
Beautiful Norway Superplex by Maniac Mike Mondo, who's been improving his in-ring skills a lot lately.
He really has. He's got improved his look, his in-ring skills. I mean, he's becoming a real wrestler.
A complete wrestler.
You know, even if he does, you know, kind of, you know, special needs.
He's still one of the sickest, most hardcore, bloody guys the company has, but he's got some moves now to back it up.
Larry, one, two. And that giant weed addict breaks up the count. Now, you want to run down the explanation on why everybody's in this particular match?
Okay. Well, Death Proof and The Order, now they are called, formerly Extreme Money, until you took it over, hate each other. I hate Vic. Vic hates me. Mondo hates Vic.
I hate Bones.
We mainly hate Vic, and you hate Bones, and, you know, Rusty and RJ. We like, you know, Rusty's on our group, and RJ, they were a team, they broke up. But, okay. Back to the story of this match in particular. Okay, Mondo beat Vic for the title. And Vic, in a tag match, had nothing to do with him, decided to help the Order win the title by hitting Thomas Extreme in the head with a bong, in which he stole off of him, because the Order are full of thieves.
No. Okay, see, here's where you're wrong there. One, the bong was not stolen.
You stole it, Jason.
I did
Patino.
Not steal it.
You stole Thomas's bong.
I found it laying in the locker room, like all this other crap that's left. Shoes, hairbrushes, makeup, coats, all this other crap that was left in the locker room. I picked it up. I took it home.
You know what? You claim to be a Republican, all, but I think you were smoking the weed.
You're out of your mind.
I think you stole it and you smoked the weed. You're just like Rush Limbaugh. You ain't nothing but a hypocrite.
Now, excuse me.
Okay, back to the match. Dropkick with Thomas's stream. I'm tired. Dropkick with Thomas Extreme.
Rush Limbaugh didn't do weed, it was Oxycontin.
Oxycontin, come on.
Europe's
shooting star right in the face, dude.
Just hit his balls in Mondo's face. Oh, nearly eliminated your special needs guy.
You mean the Milestone Revolutionary Heavyweight Champion?
Yeah, he's going to be eliminated.
As
here.
He prefers to be called.
As he prefers to be called now. He's gonna, well, Vic's getting ready to take that title from him, so.
Vic's not winning this match. There's no way. Mondo's bigger and Thomas is more talented.
You're out of your mind.
Vic's just.
I mean, I'll give you the bigger part, but I mean, you know, you eat enough cheeseburgers, you'll get big. And I guess the horse steroids don't help either, don't hurt either. See, look at that. And both guys down. Smartest wrestler in this match. That's the problem. You've got to face the notorious one who's outthinking everybody around here.
Come on, Vic.
Vic is a crafty guy. Whereas, you know, some people like to call him a dirty cheater.
It's not cheating.
The Milestone really doesn't have disqualification. So
exactly.
By technicality, it's not cheating. It's just morally wrong.
No. See, we are the moral strong points of this company. We are the ones with the moral compass and the leading Milestone.
Thomas is gonna get high here. Boom! Drop the elbow on Vic.
Absolutely beautiful elbow there. Granted, you know, he's stoned out of his mind. He could be trying to drop an elbow on a pink horse. I don't know.
Zane Riley, I mean, Mike Mondo, he kind of does look like Zane.
He does sort of look like Zane Riley a little bit.
But Mike Mondo broke up the count right there.
But I mean, Zane's got that big beard.
Yeah. He'd be good at addition to Milestone Wrestling, but
we don't agree on much, but we do agree that we like Zane Riley. Shoots him off.
Clothesline.
Just knocks
inside
his
out.
Head clean off. It's bouncing around the arena.
Anybody deserves to get their head knocked off. It's victorious.
Chunks the pot smoker out. And oh look, what's that?
Oh God, what's this?
That would be my man Tim Brody in here. Picks up a chair.
I do not like Tim Brody. Me and him have been.
Brody's awesome. Chunks the chair to him. Missile dropkick.
Oh, God. Right in the face, too.
Right in the face. Like he wasn't ugly enough.
Cheating dirty. Come on, Mondo.
1, 2, 3. Oh.
Bullshit. That's some bullshit.
Oh, look at that.
You think you're so high and mighty now. He still got to defeat Thomas Extreme to get the belt. Oh, he's not defeating Thomas.
Oh,
tonight, it's Thomas's night.
Now he done took out your champion. Now he's gonna take out the Weedhead, and we're gonna have us the tag titles, and we're gonna have us the Revolution title, and then what'll that leave? Oh, that'll leave your Smash Mouth title that we're taking.
Oh, my Smash Mouth title ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, cause JT Price is gonna take that from you.
Oh, JT Price, come on. Anyway, I've wrestled both of these men. You have it. The only person you've wrestled, Boston, was Bones. He got beat up. And me and you got squashed.
No. See, that's
but what, I've wrestled both these guys. And I can tell you, Thomas Extreme is a better athlete than Victorious.
Yes, but Vic is. I'm going to give you, but Vic is smarter and wily. Plus, he has the order.
Well, Vic is down now. Let's see. Thomas is going up top. He hits.
Come on, Brody.
He hits the 4-tip 50 is over.
Come on, Brody. Come on!
Oh! 1, 2,
grab the ref, grab
3!
Oh! Bull hockey!
And the order is still not the Milestone Revolutionary Champion.
Thomas Extreme, one half of 420, giant drug addict. He is your current reigning Milestone Revolutionary Champion. But you know what? Death proof ain't where I got that.
That's true, but Thomas may smoke the weed, and he is the champion, but at least he's not a dirty, lying, filthy melthead like Victorious. And Mike Mondo is not going to lay down. Trust me this. Who knows? I might get the Bucks.
I doubt that.
Wrestler, and I think I just hurt myself really bad. And a lot of wrestling promotions will tell you to keep this stuff to professionals, but not me. So we're Milestone Wrestling, and we love backyard wrestling, and we love blood, and we love gore, and it can keep you off drugs. And it didn't work for 420, but it worked for me. And I'm hurt. I'm really... Kids, Milestone Wrestling has a police servant asking you, please, try this at home.
It's time to get high with Milestone Wrestling. Saturday, March 12th, at the Newton National Guard Armory, Milestone presents its 8-man cruiserweight tournament. High speed, high flying, high action, high energy. See Nick Nitro, Thomas Extreme, Victorious, Rob Killjoy, and more. Plus, the Hardcore Rumble. That's Saturday, March 12th, at Newton National Guard Armory. Only $8 at the door.